right. This is from the Shishash, the third verse of the Shishash. One should chant the holy name of the Lord in a humble state of mind, thinking oneself lower than the straw in the street. One should be more tolerant than the tree, devoid of all sense of false prestige, and should be ready to offer all respects to others. In such a state of mind, one can chant the holy name of the Lord constantly. So this is a wonderful secret, you know, of how we should be chanting. Krishna has the most beautiful singers and instrument players in Goloka Vrindavan. The best mridang players, the best drummers, veena players, you know, the gopis that dance so wonderfully and chant so wonderfully. You know, who are we compared to them? You know, we can't even croak like frogs. You know, but Krishna, what Krishna really needs is our love and devotion, you know, when we're chanting. Not the beautiful voice, the fancy mridanga playing, but Krishna needs our bhakti. And for that to happen, we need to be humble. We need to approach the holy name, who is not different from Krishna himself. The holy name is a person. It's not just a mantra that we just chanting, that's making us feel good and happy and peaceful. It also does that, but that's just the side effect. You know, this Hare Krishna mantra is meant to awaken our love for Krishna by chanting his names. And all other side effects will come in, and peaceful and happy and joyful. So we just need to try and approach Krishna in that very humble state of mind. And just looking at the condition of our hearts, you know, how fallen we are. You know, the acharyas, Narottam Das Thakur, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they teach us, you know, in their wonderful songs. And these are like great acharyas who have strong faith in the chanting. And they're saying they fall. You know, they're not just saying it just like that. You know, just because it's nice to say it, or it's, you know, very poetic. But they actually mean it. And what do you speak of us? You know, we have so much lust, anger, greed, so many faults. But still, you know, we're trying to chant Krishna's holy names. And Srila Prabhupada says this is the most powerful form of prayer. My dear Krishna, I'm so fallen that I still want to chant your names. Please engage me in your service. So in that humble mood, we can approach Krishna's lotus feet. So let's try and remember this. Today is a long day. And Sachinanda Maharaj says, you know, when we have these long kirtans, we need to make a sankalpa. We need to, you know, set our mind, have a goal. You know, today I'm going to sit for 8 hours or 10 hours or 5 hours or 4 hours. And I'm going to try and focus on the holy name and chant for Krishna's pleasure. So let's try and do this. Or we start chanting, everyone taking a vow. Om Shri Krishna Pastai Bhutani Shimate Bhaktivinoda Swami Tinam Namaste Saraswati Devi, Gauravani Pichananda, Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Asthitayadi Siddhanta. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadhara, Shri Vasudi Gauravati Devi, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Yeah. Krishna, Krishna. Thank you. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.